When asked to write something nice about our brother, we struggled. It's hard to put into words what our brother means to us, but there are three things you need to know about Sam. One, Sam is always the first one with a story to fill time. Two, Sam does not know how to run his phone as well as he runs his mouth. And three, if there is a competition around, Sam will be the first one in the mix of trying to do his very best for his team. But some things you may not know about Sam that we'd like to share. When Sam started this adventure, we didn't know how many laughs or late night phone calls and surprise visits home when he's on a chapter visit nearby.
The first week Sam was gone, I realized how much I was going to miss him. Through many tears, it got better. Then I started to realize this is really his thing and I have to let it go. I've been so proud of him throughout this journey.
Throughout this process, I've been able to see more of the motivation and dedication my brother has for the FFA. I believe he has inspired others from his leadership because he has personally inspired me. Thank you for answering your call to serve the Iowa FFA.
Now we present our brother,
your 2021-2022
Southwest State Vice President,
Sam Martin.
Everybody get up, it's time to slam now. We got a real jam going down. Welcome to the Space Jam. Here's your chance, do your dance at the Space Jam. All right.
Hi, I'm Sam Martin at 11 years old, and I want to play in the NBA. That's my dream.
That was me. I had big dreams to play sports and live big. But here I am. Now, while those dreams have changed, I've learned some valuable lessons along the way. Let's start with that first dream I had, to play in the NBA. I had this dream when I first started playing basketball, a dream shared by many young athletes, to lead our team to state and someday make it to the big stage. I always wondered what it'd be like to play with my heroes on the 1992 Olympic Dream Team. Magic Johnson, Larry Bird, Michael Jordan, those are the men I looked up to. I could close my eyes as a kid, and I could hear the crowd chanting, USA, USA, USA. So it was then I made a commitment to outrun, outjump, and outwork everyone on my team, and to push myself to be better. Now, there was one thing I couldn't do. That was outgrow my teammates. My freshman year of high school, I walked into the gym, standing at an intimidating 5'3" tall and weighing 120 pounds. I was a long ways from throwing down a basketball or reaching the top shelf in the kitchen. But did that deter me? No. In my mind, I was 10-foot tall and bulletproof, and nothing was going to stop me. So sophomore year came. I grew a little, but not a lot, and I kept trying. In an effort to make myself better, I was going to the freshman-sophomore practice in the morning and then extra JV varsity practice at night, pushing myself harder and harder each day until I hit a roadblock. Next thing I knew, I was in two different hospitals with tests to determine why I was so sick. Turned out I had worked myself down to nothing, and I was sidelined while I tried to recover. It was then I took a step back, reevaluated my situation, and asked myself, is this what I really want? This whole time, I thought I'd been tracing this great dream, but now I wasn't so sure. When I had started playing basketball, it had been for the joy of the game. But now, I was playing with my head down. That's when I started to look to other things that brought me joy and competition in the past. That's when I saw it, the ag room. Now, the ag room was different. It didn't matter who you were, where you came from. When you walked into the ag room, you had a chance. When we zipped up our blue corduroy jackets, my friends turned into my family. So I got more and more involved with the program and asked myself, maybe this would be my new dream. Now there's one central piece to every good ag room, our ag teacher. They bring life, joy, laughter to each day. And I bet a lot of you out there can say you have a close relationship with your ag teacher. So can I. She's my mom. Now, my mom hasn't always taught ag. She went back to teaching when I was in sixth grade. And that's when I noticed a change. She's waking up at 5 in the morning, not coming home until 8 or 9 at night, always working in the ag room. And it wasn't until I got involved with the ag program myself that I realized why. She had this burning fire inside her to help others, to help her students. She took more joy in their success than her own success. I still didn't quite fully understand why. It wouldn't be until my senior year that I finally learned the last lesson I needed to find out what makes us champions, why we wear the blue corduroy jacket. Now, it was a cold, wet November day, and a few of us seniors were asked to go help with a service project down at the park. Now, for you seniors out there, you know there's one thing we're good at, grumbling. We were like, it's cold. I don't know. I have other things to do. But we went anyway. When we got down to the park, we found out what the service project was. We were being asked to hand out boxes of food to those in our community that were in need from Meals from the Heartland. As we handed out those boxes of food, I realized something. I saw a sincere thank you in the eyes of those we were helping, and that same fire to give my mom had in the faces of all the volunteers. IOFFA, I learned something about service that day. It will never matter how much you succeed in life if you can't help someone else along the way. We get caught up in this materialistic world of trophies, titles, and medals that some say define our success. But I challenge that. When you can help someone else, when you can help that person on your left, that person on your right, that's when true success comes. Trophies will break. Medals will get dusty, and titles will be lost. But the light you can spark in someone else will never be extinguished. The greatest act of service for me was done by a man that took up a cross and died so that I may choose him in my dream. So I ask you now, IOFFA, what are you going to do? What are you going to do when you leave here today? Are you going to help that person on your right, that person on your left, chase their dreams? Because I tell you, when you can help someone else chase their dreams, you'll find yourself achieving your own. So IOFFA, chase your dreams like a champion.